Yeah, Dig, greetings, and welcome to the Rhythmatic Drumming Channel. I'm Sal D'Amato, the host of the channel. In this video, I'm going to cover the different types of ways of covering a song. Now, in my case, it's the drums, but I believe other instruments can do the same thing. I'll have examples of my own drum covers in the description down below. There'll be links that illustrate each of the four ways. Now, number one is where you do an exact rendition of what's on the recording, what the original drummer did in the studio. Type number one, there is five drummers who are very influential and iconic, and those five drummers are the ones that I will do number one, where I'll learn all their parts, not just the feel and the groove, but each of their fills, which they themselves probably couldn't replicate in the same exact way or order if they played it again. But I do it anyway because they're so influential that I want to do that. And those five drummers are: one, Ringo Starr of the Beatles; two, Mitch Mitchell of the Jimi Hendrix Experience; three, Ginger Baker of Cream; four, John Bonham of Led Zeppelin; and five, Stuart Copeland of The Police. Those five guys, I have duplicated their parts as best as I can because their drumming is so crucial. It's as important as the guitar riff. I mean, you just have to do it in some form or another. I mean, I say that because when they go to perform these songs, in this case of Stuart, or even Neil Peart. If I were to cover a Neil Peart tune from Rush, I would have to do the same thing because even he is expected to play those parts. Those two drummers, Stuart and Neil, are expected, you know, when they're in concert to play certain parts they played. It's expected of them. Number two would be a little bit of that, number one, where you replicate key signature parts, but you add a little bit of your own self-expression. And number three, and this is my favorite one and best done with drumless song tracks, is complete self-expression, well, as much as you can, because good songs do play themselves rhythmically on drums, you know, when they have such a strong rhythmic structure. Probably, even though it's a self-expression, you're still going to sound or play a bit like what's on the record because you can't escape from that. It's just something, like I said, some songs they just play themselves and you just put your hand on the wheel and steer it a little bit. And these drum covers are where there's nothing gone before you, okay? That's the mindset, that's the scenario where it's a real world situation, and I've been doing this for a number of years where I've played hundreds of recordings, original songs, and so there was nothing before that, and I'm expected to come up with a drum part. Okay, that's your job as a drummer. And I still do that today in my studio, right here, recording drum tracks for people and clients all over the world. They gave me an original song, and I'm expected, that's my job, to come up with something that supports the vocals and the song's rhythmic structure. That's your responsibility as a professional drummer. And so number three is that kind of mindset. I go into the studio, you know, I've heard the song before, and some of the things that I'll play will be probably, sometimes will be from the original recording, but it's mainly going to be mostly my interpretation, because there's more than one way to interpret a song's rhythmic structure. And just because it's on the recording doesn't mean that's the only way or even the best way. And so sometimes I'll get comments from, they're uneducated comments from people who expect you to do what the record did, when sometimes my cover is, but I think, is better than what was on the record. And then there's number four, and this is where you use the song as a backing track, the recording as a backing track, to demonstrate your drumming prowess, as a showcase for your drumming prowess. And since you're not getting paid and you're not in a recording studio and you're not playing with the band, it's a fun thing to do where you just solo and play over the song. Another word for it is called overplaying. Now, number four is something you'd only do for yourself or to entertain people, like make a video and put it on YouTube. Because in a real world situation, if you employed this type of drumming in a band where you had no regard for what the other players are playing, you'd be kicked out of the band. And if you were on a recording session, you'd be drummed out of the studio. So it's not something, boys and girls, only try this at home. That's the exception to the rule. Don't try this at home. This is the only thing I can think of. Only do this at home. So I think that covers it. And like I said again, down below, I'll have links to my own drum covers that I've done here on YouTube that illustrate each of the four types of covers. So thank you for stopping by and checking out this video. Ciao for now. Sal.